Athena Healthcare is known as one of the most innovative EHRs. And Intermountain Healthcare has done great work in that area. What I want to know is what you see happening and what you see the opportunity as, both from your perspective as a provider and a healthcare system, and from your perspective as a leader in EHR innovation.
Yeah.
Who wants to start? Who wins?
Oh, you win.
Raise your hand.
I'm literally exhausted by the sound of my voice. I think you should start.
I don't know if that's true.
So I'll say something. I think that the key to this for us is connections and trying to find a way to take what we've been able to do, which is part of the puzzle, and work with others who have other pieces and distinctive areas and work together to do something. You have an organization like this, and this is where we are now, is a crucible of communication, really. And if we can find ways to connect those dots, then we can come together and create something compelling. On our own, we got part of the puzzle, but we need this team to help us think through the other pieces that we can't. They see around corners we don't, and this is, I think, a good way for us to do it. We stand up companies around the innovations, like what Brenda did. We've taken that and created a company around that. But in order for that to scale, we've got to be working with the organizations that are being run by Jonathan and others to make stuff happen.
Yes, I love that. We need to be working together. We need to be connecting. And HIMSS is one of those places where you really can connect and hear great ideas.
Connecting. Right now.
Yeah, the only issue
best
I have is
ever.
I completely agree. Like, connections is a metaphor for everything that is good and also bad about innovation in healthcare. It's not very connected. It would go faster if it were more connected. Some of the disconnection is ethical and appropriate. You know, you have the Hippocratic Oath. Like, don't try. In Silicon Valley, you could try something. It could literally blow up. And you'd be like, that was cool how that blew up, right? If the patient's involved, you really can't do the blow up thing. So that slows down innovation. But the other issue is there is a very long distance between the lip and the cup for entrepreneurs. You have all kinds of HIPAA, and you have, frankly, very little use of the internet. So, you know, what we do, cause, I mean, we try to invent things ourselves, but frankly, let's be honest, you get to be a couple billion dollar company, and you know, it just, you got a lot of guys rowing, but you're never, no matter how big you get, you're never going to have the best ideas. There's always going to be some kook in a basement who has the freedom from your framework that you live in, that you've succeeded in, that's going to be better. So what we've said is, from now on, everything that we build at Athena from 2015, end of 15 on, is going to be API first. It's going to be open. So not just, we started with in 11 with, let's open our patient database, our calendar appointments, et cetera, and let entrepreneurs come and build basically a really, really good interface, you know? But what we're saying now is, no, all right, that's good, but you're stuck as an entrepreneur building a fully loaded stack. You have to have a patient database. You have to have a HIPAA firewall. You have to have, you know, a directory and lookups. You have to have yada, 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 yada. And everybody's got to go build all that stuff for a product that might not work. And they got to go through an exhausting sales cycle with 15 different reasons to say no, only one of which is that it's better money, right? Is all these things that can go wrong. So what we're saying is take our calendar asset. Use it as your own. Take our directory. Take our lookup. Take our orders page. Take anything we've got and build anything you want. And we'll put it up in front of all 113,000 doctors. So now if it works, if it doesn't work, you'll know. In this model, in this era, what happens is, you know, there's 875,000 apps in the App Store. I've only seen about 100, you know. I want to see that as a reality for every doctor in every specialty, for every lab tech. And that'll speed things up.
You
right.
Create that safe environment for those things to take place.
Yes.
That's what's missing, because right now you need an environment where there are appropriate guardrails, to your point about the legal, regulatory, all those environments, but where you can still get stuff done and de-risk it early on in its life cycle, so that you aren't coming to me, you know, 3 years after you developed a product and saying, okay, here, give it to your docs. And like, you know what, if we talked about this 3 years ago, we could have helped you get this where it really should be, because right now it's not going to work. Yeah. And we can do that collaboratively and get stuff done. Otherwise, you know, it's going to be just mired in the process.
It's really interesting to me to think of what would, if this worked and everyone started doing what other markets do, if we built a safe enough developer environment for medicine, which is not the one, you know, it's a harder one to build, but we're getting really close. This is all about, let me tell you what will be true if you do it properly in 16 months, right?
Yeah. Right.
And instead, what if you could just turn it on to our second EMR, Hippocrates Open, Hippocrates Connect. We were going to do open. We decided to go to Connect. Sorry. It's Hippocrates Connect. It's not even an EMR. It's not meaningfully certified. It's basically like a personal remote for Athena Clinicals and participating Cerner accounts. Those, I have no idea if it's good or bad. We like it. Like, our demos are really good. But we will know because any doctor, without asking, without a sale, without a contract, just go to the App Store, download Connect, take a picture of the little hashtag on their medical record screen, and they're on it. Pretty soon, what if all these places, like, well, I don't know, forget the demo, just turn it on.